We often want to compare the pKa's of two species, or even two acidic protons within the same molecule. To do this, we can really break the cases down into four examples and classify those examples into one of two types. In the first type, we're dealing with a neutral acid that dissociates into an anionic conjugate base A- and a proton. The unique charged species in this case is the anion A-, and so that's really the species that's going to be the key when we're looking at the stability difference between two neutral acids, HX and HY. So what you're looking at here are two energy diagrams that illustrate two possible situations. In the situation on the left, case number one, the dissociated components, X- and Y-, are more stable than the initial neutral acids. Going downhill in energy from the starting materials to the products, we see that from HX to X- is a larger free energy change than from HY to Y-. And because that energy change is downhill, we would predict that HX would be more acidic than HY. Thinking about things in the opposite direction, we would expect Y- to be more basic than X-, because the energy from Y- to HY is less, and this is an uphill climb, than the uphill climb from X- back up to HX. So as a result, the more stable anion, just by looking at the energy diagram, is clearly X-. The strongest acid is HX because of the downhill fall from HX to X-. The weakest acid is HY, but the strongest base is Y- because from Y- up to HY is the smaller uphill climb, and the weakest base would thus be X-. Now think about the case where the dissociated species are higher in energy than the starting neutral compounds. We place the neutral compounds at the same energy because they really are similar in energy, and it's the energy difference between the charged species that really dictates why one molecule is more acidic than the other. So here we see that in going from the associated form to the dissociated form, it's HY that has the smaller energy climb. HX has to climb a larger hill in order to get to its dissociated forms. As a result, we would expect HY to be the strongest acid. Y is the more stable anion, and that's working in our favor in this case because it's a smaller uphill climb to go from HY to Y- than it is to go from HX to X-. Thus, the weakest acid would be HX, and the strongest base would be X-, and this is because the downhill fall, the exothermic reaction from X- to HX, is more favorable than the downhill reaction from Y- to HY. As a result of that, X- is the strongest base, Y- the weakest base. The other case we can think about in terms of this picture right here, in which the starting acid is charged and dissociation occurs to give a neutral conjugate base. This is what's called the type 2 acid, the last case, type 1. And within the type 2 acid manifold, we can have the same two situations where the dissociated components are either more stable or less stable than the associated, and in this case, charged components. I won't spend too much time on cases 3 and 4 because the analysis is very similar to the analysis of cases 1 and 2. But what you should recognize is that the analysis here really hinges on the stability difference between the charged species. Understanding why charged species differ in energy is thus a huge part of understanding why one molecule is more acidic than another, or even why one position is more acidic than another. In the next webcast, we'll take a look at the factors that control the stability of charges. This way, you'll be able to think about these energy differences on structural terms so that you can look at a molecule and decide whether a proton within it is likely to be acidic or not.